chart topping band Embrace, DJing alongside your brother, running live music nights in London and Manchester, and now you've bought the whole club. What's with that?
It's just going really well. Like I started doing a club night called The After Show in Manchester, and it went really well. And the owners of the venue called me in to become a partner, and eventually I just decided it'd be better if I just bought it myself. So I just bought it. It's just a really cool venue. Like when I walked in, I thought I absolutely love this place. And I never intended on buying a nightclub. Like, it's the last thing I intended on doing. But yeah, here I am. I bought one, and it's just going really well. It's full, which is cool.
You started off doing running nights in London, another music, another kitchen.
Yeah.
And then you moved up to Manchester with the After Show.
Yeah.
Why the move to Manchester?
Because Manchester's really cool. It's got, like, really strong musical heritage, and around that time when I moved, there was a lot of really cool bands coming out of Manchester. Like, I booked the Ting Tings before I even had a venue for my club night, and I booked them for £50, which was pretty cool. It was before they got signed and stuff. But there's a lot of really good bands coming out of Manchester as well at the moment. Bands like Delphic, Kid British, a new band called The Hot Nimes that you won't have heard of yet, but you will, because they're really good.
So who else has gone through? You mentioned the Ting Tings, Twisted Wheel.
Yeah.
Who?
There's just, at the moment in Manchester, there's just so many good bands. There's a band called, Gideon Conn and his band. They're really good. Delphic, I mentioned earlier, they've got their first single, Counterpoint, coming out in a few weeks' time, and already like Enemy and Radio 1 and all that are getting on board, which is really cool. Kid British are working on their album, but they've already got like support slots with the Enemy and the Specials and stuff. And this new band that I mentioned, Hot Knives, I don't think they've done a gig yet. I'm trying to book them for the After Show, but they're saying like, who else is playing, which like, I really like that. It means that they've got a real sort of attitude already. It's like, I really like that.
It gives
me a sense that they're going to be big, you know.
Are they a Manchester band?
Yeah.
Manchester based. Okay, and what other nights are you running there?
Doing that called Invention, which is on a Sunday. We've got a lot of other really good nights though. I've got a night called Audio Farm. That was just them in the background actually bringing all their gear in. They've got everything. They've got like a full-size cow, bales of hay, an Oxfam shop, beat matching masseurs, people like going around doing henna tattoos, and it's just like an indoor festival. It's pretty mental.
Have you got other promoters coming in for other nights or?
Yeah, we've got Whatever the Weather and Bass Camp do a monthly Friday. They're the biggest drum and bass and dubstep night in Manchester. Then I've got other nights doing a night called Propaganda that do a weekly Saturday. And then there's a night called This Feeling that put on bands, and they've had all kinds of people like Sabian and the Enemy and Star Sailor and all those people come through the doors on their club night. And another night called Indigo, which is kind of a bit like the After Show, really, but it's on a different Friday. That gets really busy as well. And then a really weird night called Pop Bubble Rock, that's kind of like punk pop stuff. But it gets really busy, and it's every other Wednesday, oddly, so it's busy.
Keeps you busy, I should imagine.
Yeah, certainly does.
You've put some massive names through through the After Show. What other big names are coming through Moho can we expect soon?
Well, tonight we've got Derek May, who's like big techno legend, coming over from Detroit to do his stuff. And we've had quite often when we book American acts, they end up getting stuck at customs. We had like Ghostface Killah got sent back for drug dealing, and Pharaoh Monch didn't have a work permit, so he got sent back. But we've had a lot of big names come through. Goldie Looking Chain did a gig here recently. We've got Sunshine Underground coming up. 100 Reasons just did a gig, so it's a good place to do a gig because it's got a low ceiling and it's just got that sort of intimate atmosphere that bands love and crowds love.
Okay. Manchester, it's got like a massive sort of live scene anyway. How has it fared amongst the competition? Would you say it's sort of right in there now, or because it's a fairly new club? Yeah.
Venue. It's the busiest. It's a fact already. We're like the biggest club in the centre of town for live music now.
Okay, and how are the Mancunians taking you? Because you're a Yorkshire boy originally, aren't you?
I don't know. I've never had a bad word said, really. Most people are just really friendly. I think they like the fact that a guy who's in a band is devoting his time to getting like new bands' attention, and I'm quite helpful as well when we've got... When I'm doing my after show night, if a band want advice and stuff, I'm usually pretty helpful with it and stuff. So I've not really had anything negative. It's all been really positive, really.
And so you've done a few partnerships before. You've done Versus, XFM, In the City. Can we expect anything more of that this year?
Yeah, I've been speaking to Filter Magazine. Versus Cancer wanted to do some more stuff. Radio 1 wanted to do something over the In the City weekend. Yeah, I'm always open to working with new people. It keeps it fresh, you know.
For sure.
So yeah, definitely. We've got this Hungry Pigeon Festival coming up in May, which should be really good. There's a Hungry Pigeon versus the After Show coming up on May the 22nd, which I think will be a really good one.
Okay, what is it, a whole festival or a day?
Yeah, they're doing a whole festival, and our night's kind of the big part of it, big chunk of it, so should be good.
And for In the City with the Radio 1, that sounds massive.
Yeah,
what have you got planned?
Stevens, hopefully. It's all still just in the talking stage at the moment, but I want to do something that promotes new bands, brand new bands.
And in terms of Embrace, did you guys disband or...?
No, we're still together. Richard's been busy writing. I'm going to start again in the next few weeks once I get most of this club up and running on its own a little bit more. I'm looking forward to it as well. I have been writing. Every time I sit down at a piano or a guitar, I seem to come up with something that's really good. So once I can devote a bit of solid time to it, I'm sure it's going to be good.
And will it be a similar sort of sound you'll be looking at? I know you did a...
I don't think so, no, because... I've kind of, there's a real sort of unique kind of identity about what we do, and a kind of a different kind of frequency, a different kind of soul to what we do than what anybody else does, and I think that keeps us unique. But in terms of stylistically, I'm really interested in all kinds of different stuff now. I listen to so many new bands, and I've had so many different people come along, artists, and from, you know, artists, video artists, installation artists, or sculptors, or painters, or authors, or just in the last 3 years since we did the last album, I've had such a varied, full, and exciting life that I've got a lot more to write about, and a much broader perspective on our own stuff, because I've been away from it, and haven't been away from it before for any period longer than a few weeks since I was 17, so literally the gaps between albums before was just me working on the next one or us working on the next one. But this time round, I've had like 2 or 3 years away from doing any writing at all, and eager to get back now and change the world again, you know. But I've got a meeting's just come, my next meeting, so I'm gonna have to go, Rasheen, if that's alright.
Yeah, no worries.
Yeah,
dude.
Is that enough for you?
Yeah, it should be cool.